Cile di onore.
Invitamos a los señores asistentes a sentarse a fin de dar luz.
Laudator Jesus Christus. And welcome to the live broadcast of the visit of His Holiness Pope Francis to the government authorities, members of civil society, and the diplomatic corps at the government palace in Lima, Peru. For Vatican News, I am Sister Bernadette Reese, and joining me for this broadcast is Deacon Cesar. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you, Sister Bernadette. It is a great joy to share this moment with you.
We see here His Holiness greeting the President of Peru, President Kuczynski, and his wife. A welcome to all of you joining us from CBS News, Shalom World TV, EWTN, Salt and Light, Radio Maria, and Catholic TV. This is His Holiness' state visit. We're now hearing a children's orchestra from Manche. The president now accompanying the Holy Father to the podium. Present at today's event are members of both religious and civil society, entrepreneurs,
favor tomar asiento. Señoras y señores, buenas tardes. Con la presencia del señor presidente de la República, Pedro Pablo Kuczynski, se da inicio al encuentro de su santidad, el Papa Francisco, con el señor presidente, autoridades del Estado, cuerpo diplomático y sociedad civil, en el marco de su visita oficial a la República del Perú.
And so begins the meeting, the official meeting among the heads of state, His Holiness and President Kuczynski, with various members of civil society, the diplomatic corps, and entrepreneurs.
Bienvenido, Santo Padre, Papa Francisco.
Welcome, Holy Father, Pope Francis. Welcome to this House of Government.
Bienvenidas, autoridades civiles.
A welcome all the authorities, civil and church authorities.
Y sobre todo, bienvenidos ciudadanos.
Welcome military authorities and citizenship, citizens.
Esta plaza integra nuestra historia.
This square is made of our history.
En el Palacio de Gobierno,
here,
había hace muchos
in the government palace,
de años atrás,
many years ago,
el jefe Taulichusco.
It was
todavía hay debajo de esta parte del palacio una huaca, una ruina preincaica. Y encima de ella se
construyeron los
palacios. Esta es la última versión terminada en 1930.
They built different palaces.
Y tenemos al frente la catedral.
And we have in front the cathedral.
La catedral que tiene más o menos 250 años.
The cathedral that it has about 250 years.
Otra iglesia que estuvo ahí antes.
But it's also replacing another church that it was there before.
De los terremotos.
Because sadly, we are in the land of the earthquakes.
Y tenemos aquí los símbolos de una cultura.
We have here the symbols of a culture, a millennial culture.
Se han encontrado hace poco en Ayacucho.
They have found
los restos
somehow
de una cultura que empezó hace 20,000 años.
A culture that began many years ago.
Al norte de Lima hay una cultura que floreció hace 20,000
años. In the north of Lima, there's a culture that flourished 5,000 years ago.
Hoy usted pudo ver,
this is a country that you have seen, Holy Father, a part of the Amazons.
Pero uno sube el cerro y llega a la tierra de los mil valles.
This is a land of 1,000 valleys.
En un valle no sabe lo que hay en el otro. Por eso el Perú ha sido un país cuya historia.
Peru has been a country whose history is integration and the fight to be united in one country. Now, I believe that it's important to remember that 30 years ago, the Holy Father, John Paul II, was here in his second visit. The first visit was 1985, and he came back in 1988. This was a difficult time for Peru. It was a time that terrorism flourished, high inflation and other bad things. It was a time of transition. Now, 30 years after, we need to remember what have happened these past three decades.
Cicatrizando las heridas del pasado.
We have healed wounds, but this is a process that is not easy. It is a process that is going on. We hope that this process of peace and dialogue that are fundamental for the citizens of a country, they can feel better, more according to their aspirations, for their sons, for their children, may have a better future. For this, we have talked about a social revolution that began years back, but that this continues in stages. To progress, we need not only economical growth, but we need the social revolution in health, in education, housing, but overall that the population can feel that their aspirations are fulfilled in this life and not another. These past 3 years, 30 years, Peru has grown. For this, Holy Father, we want to welcome you to renew our faith, not for 30 years. I don't want to wait too long. But for now, Holy Father, give us a push towards peace and dialogue. We are united for hope. This is your visit purpose, Holy Father. We are united in the same vision, a vision of revolution and social progress. United in hope, we believe that we will reach with dialogue, with your message, Holy Father. Welcome. Welcome, Holy Father.
Seguidamente, discurso de su santidad, el Papa Francisco.
Señor Presidente, miembros del gobierno y del cuerpo diplomático.
Mr. President, members of the government and the diplomatic corps, distinguished authorities, representatives of civil society, ladies and gentlemen, dear friends. As I arrive at this historic edifice, I thank God for this opportunity to be on Peruvian soil. I would like my words to be a message of greeting and esteem for each of the sons and daughters of this people that down the years has preserved and enriched the wisdom handed down by its forebears and represents indeed one of its greatest legacies.
Gracias, señor Pedro Pablo Kuczynski.
Thank you, Mr. Pedro Pablo Kuczynski, President of the Nation, for your invitation to visit the country and for your words of welcome offered on your behalf. My visit to Peru has as its theme, United by Hope. If I may say so, seeing this land is itself a reason for hope.
Parte de vuestro territorio está compuesto por la Amazonía que visitamos.
Part of your territory includes the Amazon, which I visited this morning. It is overall the largest tropical forest and the most extensive river system on the planet. This lung, as it has been called, is one of the world's regions of great biodiversity, as it is home to a vast variety of species. Yours, too, is a wealth of variety of cultures, which increasingly intermingle and which make up the soul of this people. It is a soul characterized by ancestral values such as hospitality, esteem for others, respect and gratitude for Mother Earth, and creativity for new initiatives. It is marked likewise by a shared sense of responsibility for the development of all, joined to a solidarity that has often shown itself in your response to different disasters you have experienced.
En este contexto, quisiera señalar a los jóvenes. Ellos son.
In this regard, I would like to point to the young. They are the most vital gift that this society possesses. With their dynamism and enthusiasm, they promise and encourage us to dream of a hope-filled future, born of the encounter between our lofty ancestral wisdom and the new eyes that youth offers.
Y me alegro también de un hecho histórico.
I also take pleasure in a historical fact that hope in this land has the face of holiness. Peru has given birth to saints that blazed paths of faith for the entire American continent. To name just one, Martin of Porres, a son of two cultures, showed the strength and richness that comes about when people focus on love. I could continue at length with this list of reasons, material and spiritual, for hope. Peru is a land of hope that invites and challenges its people to unity. This people has the duty to maintain unity, among other things, precisely to defend all these reasons for hope.
Sobre esta esperanza apunta una sombra, se cierne una amenaza.
Yet over this hope, a shadow is growing. A threat looms. Never has humanity had such power over itself, yet nothing ensures that it will be used wisely, particularly when we consider how it is currently being used. This was taken from the encyclical Laudato Si. This is evident in the way that we are stripping the earth of its natural resources, without which no forms of life are possible. The loss of jungles and forests means not only the loss of species, which could also be extremely important resources for the future, but also the loss of vital relationships that could end up altering the entire ecosystem. In this context, being united in defense of hope means promoting and developing an integral ecology as an alternative to an outdated model of development that continues to produce human, societal, and environmental decline. This calls for listening to local persons and peoples, recognizing and respecting them as valid partners in dialogue. They preserve a direct link to the land. They know its times and ways, and so they know the catastrophic effects produced in the name of development by many projects. The vital fabric that constitutes the nation is thus being altered. The degradation of the environment, sad to say, cannot be separated from the moral degradation of our communities. We cannot think of these as two separate realities. For example, black market mining has become a danger that is destroying people's lives. Forests and rivers are being destroyed with all the richness they possess. This process of degradation brings with it and encourages organizations operating outside of legal structures. These debase so many of our brothers and sisters by subjecting them to human trafficking, a new form of slavery, irregular employment and crime, and to other evils that gravely affect their dignity and at the same time the dignity of the nation. Working together to defend hope demands that we remain very attentive to that other, often subtle form of environmental degradation that increasingly contaminates the whole system of life. Corruption. How much evil is done to our Latin American people and the democracies of this continent by this social virus, a phenomenon that infects everything, with the greatest harm being done to the poor and Mother Earth. Everything being done to combat this social scourge deserves our utmost attention and help. This is a battle that involves all of us. Being united in defense of hope requires a greater culture of transparency among public entities, the private sector, and civil society. No one can be excluded from this process. Corruption is preventable and calls for commitment on the part of all.
A quienes ocupan algún cargo de responsabilidad,
I encourage and urge all those in positions of authority in whatever sphere to insist on this path in order to bring your people and your land the security born of feeling that Peru is a place of hope, an opportunity for all. For all, and not just for a few. In this way, all Peruvians can feel that this country is theirs, that here they can relate fraternally and equitably with their neighbors and help others in their need, a land where they can realize their own future. And in this way, to forge a Peru that makes room for people of all bloods, a land in which the promise of Peruvian life can be achieved. I wish to renew in your presence the commitment of the Catholic Church, which has accompanied the life of this nation in this joint effort to continue working so that Peru will continue to be a land of hope. May Saint Rose of Lima intercede for each of you and for this blessed nation. Thank you once again. Our Holy Father, having completed his discourse, now retiring into the government palace, accompanied by President Kuczynski. Here they will meet privately together and exchange gifts. Here we see the Holy Father having entering the palace, now being escorted with President Pablo Kuczynski.
Informamos a los asistentes en el patio de honor a permanecer en sus tribunas.
After this private visit, the Holy Father and the President will retire to the peace room, and the Holy Father will be able to meet the President's family. After that, the Holy Father will then bless the functionaries and staff of the government palace in the dining room, and then he will be once again accompanied to the courtyard of honor in front of the palace. Immediately following this meeting, the Holy Father will go to the Church of St. Pedro in Lima, where he will meet in private the Jesuit community. And tomorrow, the Holy Father will travel to the Archdiocese of Trujillo, where he will celebrate Mass and have some other appointments with the priests, religious, and seminarians from the northern part of Peru. And he will take part in a Marian celebration in the evening. And then he will return to Lima tomorrow by plane in the evening. This now concludes our broadcast of the Holy Father's visit in Lima to the government authorities, the members of civil society, diplomatic corps, at the government palace in Lima. I'd like to thank you all for joining us this evening on behalf of Vatican News. I am Sister Bernadette, and thank you once again for joining us, Deacon Cesar.
Thank you, Sister Bernadette, and God bless. God bless you all.
Laudetur Jesus Christus.